Due to the difficulties involved in measuring evaporation directly, it is usually preferable to estimate the evaporation from meteorological data. This short video lecture introduces the Penman-Monteith equation for estimating the evaporation. Useful meteorological data, for instance, for estimating the evaporation, can be obtained after installing a meteorological station. This is a picture of a meteorological station set up in the Pays de Bouche of the Hautes Alpes in France. Measurements are made of the wind direction, wind speed, solar radiation, temperature and relative humidity, and precipitation is measured in a tipping bucket rain gauge. This is a picture showing the variation of vapor pressure, relative humidity, and air temperature during a day. On the vertical axis, we have the vapor pressure in millibar or hectopascal, and the relative humidity as a percentage. The relative humidity as a fraction is the actual vapor pressure divided by the saturation vapor pressure at that same temperature. The saturation vapor pressure is a function of temperature. Here, on this vertical axis, we have temperature. The temperature changes over the day. In the morning, it's cold. During the day, it gets warmer. And in the evening, it cools down. In this example, the actual vapor pressure stays the same over the day. But because of the changing temperature, the value of the saturation vapor pressure changes. And because of this, the relative humidity changes. Because temperatures are low in the morning, the relative humidity in the morning is high. And because temperatures are higher in the afternoon, the relative humidity then is low. Due to the difficulties involved in measuring evaporation directly, it is usually preferable to estimate the evaporation from meteorological data. The evaporation rate is controlled by the energy needed to diffuse water vapor into the atmosphere, the Earth's surface energy balance, and the atmospheric demand for water vapor. The Penman-Monteith equation shown here, named after the work of British physicist Penman in 1948 and Monteith in 1973, is a physically based method for estimating the actual evaporation Ea, or under unstressed conditions, the potential evaporation Ep, based on both the energy balance and atmospheric demand. The heat transfer into a soil, rock, or water body is relatively small and can often be neglected. If we set this to zero and insert values for the constants and near constants into the Penman-Monteith equation, this is the equation we get. Ea is the actual evaporation in millimeter per day. Rn is the net radiation at the Earth's surface in megajoule per square meter and per day. Es minus Ea is the saturation deficit in kilopascal. Delta is the gradient of the saturation vapor pressure curve, or the Clausius-Clapeyron graph for water in kilopascal per degree Celsius, thus dependent on the temperature, and Rs and Ra are resistances. Ra is the aerodynamic resistance. It is the resistance encountered by water vapor in diffusing into the air from a vegetation surface, thus it is the resistance against interception evaporation. It is reciprocal to the roughness of the Earth's surface and the wind speed near the surface. Both a rougher surface and more wind cause more turbulent mixing of the air and thus a smaller resistance to evaporation. RS is the surface resistance. It is a physiological resistance imposed by vegetation stomata on the movement of water vapor by transpiration. It varies with water availability, the soil moisture content. RS and RA are resistances. They are typically expressed in second per meter, the reciprocal of meter per second. The Earth's surface energy balance. There's radiation from the sun. Part of the radiation that reaches the Earth's surface is reflected. Alpha is the albedo, or reflection coefficient. It's the fraction of incoming radiation that is reflected. Part of the incoming radiation is absorbed. Sn is the absorbed shortwave radiation at the Earth's surface. Rn is the net radiation at the Earth's surface and can be determined as the difference between the net incoming shortwave radiation that is absorbed, Sn, and the net outgoing radiation at the Earth's surface, Ln. These radiation values are in megajoule per square meter and per day. The incoming radiation is shortwave because the sun has a high temperature. The outgoing radiation is longwave because the Earth has a low temperature. This net radiation energy at the surface, Rn, is used for warming the soil below the surface by soil heat transfer, G, warming the air by sensible heat transfer from the Earth's surface, H, and or latent heat transfer, which is evaporation from the Earth's surface, lambda Ea. G, H, and lambda Ea are all expressed in megajoule per square meter and per day, and are assigned a positive value when directed away from the surface. Besides the net radiation Rn as a source of energy, the atmospheric demand for water vapor also plays an important role in evaporation. This is shown by Es minus Ea in the Penman-Monteith equation. Es is the saturation vapor pressure at the evaporating surface in kilopascal, and Ea is the actual vapor pressure of the air above the evaporating surface, also in kilopascal. Es and Ea are estimated for the same air temperature. The difference between Es and Ea is called the saturation deficit in kilopascal. The larger the saturation deficit, the higher the evaporation rate will be. This slide shows the online resource center or companion website of my textbook. As an interactive spreadsheet, it contains a worked-out example of the Penman-Monteith evaporation, comparing the evaporation from a forest, grassland, and open water. The spreadsheet allows you to insert input values on meteorological data, such as air temperature, relative humidity, sun shortwave radiation, number of bright sunshine hours per day, and the total day length, and land use data, the albedo, the aerodynamic resistance, and the surface resistance for forest, grassland, and open water. This shows the spreadsheet lower down. Here we have the output on evaporation in millimeter per day for forest, grassland, and open water. The lower evaporation rate for forest than grassland is due to the high value of the surface resistance of the forest, and the high value of the open water evaporation is due to the low albedo value, so a low reflection of solar radiation, and, of course, the absence of a surface resistance. Allen and co-workers recommend the FAO Penman-Monteith equation as the sole standard method for computation of the reference crop evaporation, ERC, in millimeter per day. This equation is the Penman-Monteith equation for a grass crop height of 0.12 meter, a standardized height for wind speed, temperature, and humidity measurements at 2 meter above ground level, an albedo of 0.23, an aerodynamic resistance in second per meter of 208 divided by U2, where U2 is the wind speed in meter per second at 2 meter, and a surface resistance of 69 second per meter. Gamma is the psychrometric constant, and T is the air temperature in degrees Celsius. In order to estimate the potential evaporation of a particular crop, it is common practice to calculate the above-defined reference crop evaporation and to multiply this by the crop coefficient, Kc, of the particular crop as determined from research, for instance, by using a lysimeter. The value of Kc changes with the growth state of the crop.